Traditionally, this is the night when families are together to share their love and friendship, to enjoy the true and reverent meaning of this night of nights. It was many years ago that shepherds watched their flocks at night, and an angel of the Lord spoke to them, of a babe wrapped in swaddling cloth and lying in a manger. And a star led them to Bethlehem. This night, 1961, the star still shines in each home throughout the nation, casting its light of hope, faith, and goodwill. Scott's Men's and Boys Wear wish to say to their many friends and customers a cheerful and festive holiday greeting, and hope that the star of so long ago continues to shine on you and yours. And now, 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. All right now, Susie and Dale, it's time you went to bed. Santa Claus will soon be coming. You don't want to go to bed? Well, what do you want Daddy to do?
I want you to read that story.
The night before Christmas?
Yeah.
Would you like me to read it? Then you go right to bed afterward,
yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay? All right? All righty. Now you settle back and get on Daddy's lap, and you listen to this as Daddy reads it to you, all right?
What?
'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
Ow.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced through their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be who?
St. Nicholas.
That's right. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Do you know their names?
Yeah.
What?
Cupid.
Cupid is one. What are the rest of them? Dasher.
Yes.
And Dancer.
And Dancer.
And Prancer.
And Prancer.
And Vixen.
And Vixen.
And, as you said, Cupid. And
Cupid.
And Comet.
And Comet.
And Donner and Blitzen.
And Donner and Blitzen.
To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
And after a red-nosed reindeer.
Yes? Rudolph may have been...
Baby, can I sing you Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer? So a shiny nose, and if you ever saw you, and say hello. I'm a reindeer who's working all the day. We never put Rudolph's shiny nose on the reindeer game. Then one foggy Christmas tree, that's who can you say? Stop with you, know, so why won't you sound like I do now? Then how do you get something? Then they shout and I'm green. You're going out in history.
That's very good. Now let Daddy continue it. Was the night before Christmas, right? As the leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry.
Yeah.
See Santa Claus here in this picture?
But his nose is like a cherry.
That's yeah. Right.
And his nose be like a chew, I ain't gonna eat his nose off.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. Then Santa Claus wouldn't have any nose. And the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke had encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
Yes, and he likes a jelly.
I'm gonna eat him up. Yeah, he was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
Daddy, you been excited and I'm gonna talk?
Yes, honey. Soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings and then turned with a jerk.
Nobody. I saw the last time you went out for a day, we saw Santa Claus and an eight reindeers running with toys, and he gave us them.
Did he?
Yeah.
Well, you know what Santa did then after he put all the toys around the tree? Mm. He put a finger aside of his nose like this, and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose.
What's this thing I hear?
Well, that's just something he did. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team, gave a whistle. Can you give a whistle like Santa Claus might give? Well, maybe like that. And away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, way up in the sky, didn't he? But you know what he said as he drove out of sight?
He said, ho, ho, ho.
Yes, and he said, happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
And I like my Santa.
You do.
The next time he comes and it gets too close, I'm going to kiss him because he's my best Santa Claus in the whole world. I like him so much. So.
You do. Well, now, you know what? If you like Santa Claus so much, you better get ready and go to bed before Santa Claus comes for his visit. Otherwise, he won't come if you're up. And you want to get up early in the morning and all the toys that Santa Claus will leave you. Okay?
And it gets small and I'm going to get up.
What are you going to do when you get up in the morning? What do you suppose?
What do you suppose
he's going to bring in? A fire truck?
Yeah, I'm going to get up and see it.
What about you, Susie? What do you think he's going to bring you?
A sniffle.
A sniffle style?
Yeah.
And what else do you suppose? What else do you want, Santa?
That's all I want.
That's all. That's all. What about you, Dale? Do you want anything besides a fire truck?
Yeah, I want a whole bunch of things.
You want a whole bunch of things?
Well, I'm a cartoon.
Well, in order for Santa to bring you anything, I think that you had better get ready for bed, all righty?
Okay.
But Santa Claus will soon be coming. And you don't want to be up when he's here. Now listen, what would you say if I put a record, if Daddy puts a record on and lets you sing? Would you like that? How about something like Santa Claus is Coming to Town? Everybody, come on now, sing Susie and Dave. Sing along with the music.
You better watch out. You better not cry. Better not cry.
Better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you. Now that the children are all safely tucked in bed on this night before Christmas, Scott's Men's and Boys Wear at the Lockport Plaza again remind all of you of their sincere wishes for the holiday season. May you and yours have the happiest of holidays together with your families. Scott's Men's and Boys Wear at the Lockport Plaza has presented for your Christmas Eve entertainment, Twas the Night Before Christmas, a special feature of our Christmas Eve lineup of entertainment. We invite you to stay tuned for the remainder of the evening for outstanding Christmas Eve entertainment on Radio WUSJ.